let us learn the poem for a five-year-old written by Fleur Adcock. Fleur Adcock is a British citizen who was born in New Zealand in 1934. She worked as a librarian in London. She has also edited the fabled book of 20th century women's poetry. Many of her poems are about the everyday experience of women as a wife and a mother. The poem for a five-year-old tells us about the contradiction in our dealings. There is a difference between what we preach and what we really practice. So this poem shows us what we speak and what we do, the differences. The contradiction. We say something and we do another thing. So, the Fleur Adcock says the daily experience of women. So, before we are going to the poem, let us think of the mother and the child relationship. It is very close, closest relationship we have. The child cannot live without a mother. Mother cannot live without a child. So it is very, they are very bonded, means very close. So whatever the mother says, the child listens. So mother is the best and first teacher for the child, 1 to 5 years. So whatever the mother says, the child does. So child will not know anything. Mother has to teach. Let us see what will happen in this form. A snail is climbing up the window sill. You might have seen the snail. Yes, after night rain, morning if you see, many creatures, they are coming to our house. Caterpillar, snail, so like that. We see the small creatures after the rain. So here the snail is climbing up the window sill. Window sill means lower wooden frame of the window, usually flat and broad. You go to your house and see the window sill. So the snail is climbing up the window sill into your room after a night of rain. It is coming to your room after a night of rain. You call me to see and I explain. Here you means the boy. You call me means the mother. You call me in to see and I explain. Now any child, anything sees, the creatures, the snail or caterpillar or lizard, anything, and child sees, it gets frightened and runs and tells to the mother to come and see, calls the mother to come and see the creature. So like that, you call me in to see and I explain your mother, I explain what it is. That it would be unkind to leave it there. So here the child sees the snail and calls the mother. Mother says that it would be unkind to leave it there. If you leave there in the windowsill, it is unkind. It is not kindness. It might crawl to the floor, we must take care. It may crawl, it may come slowly to the floor and we must take care. What will happen? That snail comes to the floor, that no one squashes it. You understand? That no one squashes. Squashes means here crust and under their foot. They should not smash it, the snail. You understand? Mother says, you understand? To the 5-year-old boy. And carry it outside with careful hand to eat a daffodil. The mother says, carry the snail and leave it way on the daffodil to eat. So daffodil is a flower. So to eat that, to live, the snail has to live, right? So mother says, take slowly and leave it on the daffodil. I see then that a kind of faith prevails. Here, I see then that one kind of faith prevails. Faith prevails means it is common. commonly believe that character is built rather by words of advice than by imitation of what others actually do. Of course, this is not true. It is only a prevailing belief, not based on truth. So here, what is the meaning of that? We think that the child will learn imitating mother, imitating father, imitating children, neighbor. The child will learn the character, but it is not. The child can change it. That is the meaning of here. I see then that a kind of fate prevails. We believe that the child is, by imitating others, the child learns the character, builds the character. That is our faith. Your gentleness is molded still by words. Your gentleness. So molded, our character, the child characters molded by others, by words. What others speak, what father speaks, what mother speaks, what relative speaks, friends. Like that, the child learns. From you who have trapped mice and shot wild birds. From me who drowned your kittens who betrayed. Here, from me means mother. From me who have trapped mice and shot wild birds. What mother is doing? Mother is trapping the mice. Your mothers also do. When the mice comes to your house, they keep to catch that. You might have seen the trapping. They keep one kind of box. The mice, then they keep some rice. The mice will go inside and it caught. And what they do afterwards? They will put in the water. The mice, they kill it. Then they shot wild birds. Shooting of the wild birds, killing of the birds. From me, who drowned your kittens, who betrayed. When kitten comes, what kitten do? The cat comes and drinks the milk. So they destroy the kitchen, whatever they want, they eat. So what they do here? The ladies in the kitchen, they kill. They drown, means they put in the water and drown the kittens there. They kill it, actually. Your closest relatives and who pervade. So your closest relatives learned this. Closest relatives, they learned from me all this killing of the mice, killing of the wild birds and killing of the kittens, all this. The harshest kind of truth to many another. But this is harshest, as of killing the cat, killing the mice, killing the wild birds. It is very harsh. We are harsh towards the nature. So we learn, your closest relatives also learn from me like this. She's telling, the mother is telling. But that is how things are. Yes, present is, that is how things are. We say, do something, we say something. We say something, we do another thing. There is a contradiction between what we do and what we say. I am your mother and we are kind to snake. I am your mother, I am telling you, you have to be kind to the snake. Here we see children. The what mother says, be kind to the snake. And what she is doing, she is killing up the kittens, birds and the mice. So is it right? No. The mother is doing a wrong thing here. She has to, when she says to the child, you take care of the snake, she also should take care of the other animals. She should not kill the animals. She should not trap the mice and kill the wild animals. The same way she also has to be kind to other animals. So here see, she teaches good things to the child, but she is doing wrong way where she has to do. So this is the contradiction we live in this world. We say something and do another thing. We have, whatever we say, we have to practice that first. Then only after seeing our example, we have to give example to others. Understood, children? Okay. We should not have any contradiction in our life. What we say, we have to do it. What we won't say, should not do it. Understood? Okay, children. You learn this form. You read once again and answer the questions and